Hi, I'm Debbie and I live at Sunrise Farm, which is the home of Horses Helping People, and we're off-grid. Previously, we were living at a rented yard, and again, we were off-grid and we had to run a generator, which was expensive, it was noisy, the smell of the diesel was awful, you've always got the worry of the pollution. But for a short-term option, it wasn't worth us actually getting onto on-grid because the costs of connection were about £55,000. We really wanted to find a long-term home for our therapeutic horsemanship centre, but in Buckinghamshire, the costs are really high, so we couldn't afford to buy somewhere with facilities. So we wrote to all the farmers in the area to see if anyone had got a few acres that we could buy. We only got one reply, but one reply is all you need. So here we are at Sunrise Farm. When we moved in, we hadn't got planning permission, so that was the next stage. We thought a grid connection would be straightforward because there was an electricity pole at the gate, but it turned out to be the wrong sort of electricity, and they wanted £50,000 for a connection. They brought the price down to £35,000, but it was still way outside our budget. So we bought a generator that we thought would serve our needs, but actually it was so expensive to run, and we had the same problems with it being noisy, with it being expensive, and with the pollution again. So we settled temporarily for running a small generator. The same problems, it's still noisy, it still uses a lot of petrol, and you've still got the pollution problem. And the added problem is being small, it doesn't run all the electricity that you need. So particularly for the business, we really couldn't develop in the way we wanted to. So we decided to look at the option of solar panels. We originally got three quotes for solar panels. At the time, we couldn't go ahead because we couldn't quite afford it. But meanwhile, on an off-grid forum, I heard about solar plants and I had a look at the website and I was really impressed with what I saw. First of all, there was a dedicated off-grid department. The testimonials and reviews all looked really good. So I decided to contact them and have a chat. I was straight away put through to Ian, who actually runs the off-grid department, and he has a specialist knowledge. So you're not talking to a salesman, you're talking to the person that knows what they're talking about. And so Ian came out for a site survey and we felt really confident that this was the guy that could go ahead and do us a really good solar panel installation. When the installation was booked, it was for January, so Ian and Scott came down on one of the coldest 5 days of the year, but they were fantastic. They just got on with their work. We were carrying on with our business with clients on site, and Ian and Scott were always totally unobtrusive, so it was no problem with them being around with the clients. And they also had all the time in the world for my endless stupid questions of how it worked. Nothing was too much trouble, and they did a great job. Building a house off-grid has been a lot of fun, but also very challenging. For us, it's a real budget build, and we've had to learn the skills as we go along because we couldn't afford to pay a lot of people to do the work. So one of the challenges was that we started building before the solar panels were in place. So sometimes we had to use our own power rather than power tools. But it's been great actually planning right from the design of the build and making it as eco-friendly as possible, because that's one of our philosophies, is that we want to leave a smaller footprint on the earth as we can. The build is a timber frame, and one of the key things about it is that it's super insulated. So hopefully it will be nice and warm in winter as well as cool in summer. And that seems to be working so far. We like to use natural products where possible. So we've used a mix of wood fibre insulation and sheep's wool on the inside. The building itself is clad in larch, and it's been a real pleasure to actually work alongside some of the craftsmen that have been involved in the build with us. Horses Helping People is a therapeutic horsemanship centre, which means we bring people and horses together with the hope of benefiting the people's lives in some way, whether that's emotional, physical or mental well-being. But we're great believers that that should be done with no detriment to the horse's mental, emotional or physical well-being. So we see horses as the partners in our work rather than just objects or tools that we use. Having the solar panels has been huge for us. It means that we can develop our business in a really positive way. Previously, we couldn't provide a warm, heated space for the clients, and we didn't have lights to continue sessions in the winter after dark. But now the admin can be done by volunteers during the day, and it's made a huge difference. And as residents here at Sunrise Farm, it's made a difference to us as individuals as well. Simple things like having a fridge freezer that most people take for granted. You just can't run one of those off of a small generator. So it's delightful just to be able to go in the fridge freezer, get out the ice cream and the ice cubes in this heat wave, and really enjoy the benefits of having our solar panels. In the winter, you may need to top up with a bit of generator, but actually we've had these panels in since January, and we've run our generator for a total of 2 hours to top up in all that time. So it's so easy compared with the smell and the noise of running a generator. We get really good backup from solar plants as well. When they installed the solar panels, they showed us the app that we could use to monitor the solar panels. So even if we're out for the day, we can have a look on the app and see how the solar panels are doing. And we also get a lot of support ongoing from Ian back at the off-grid department. So if we've got any questions about the ongoing use of the solar panels, there's no problem with us getting in touch. We're never made to feel like a nuisance or anything like that. So I would really recommend solar plants for anyone that's thinking of having a solar panel installation.